मेरी दीदी की शादी हुई थी ना तो कर्जा पैसे लिए थे.
We had taken a loan, you know, to pay for my sister's marriage. The farmers, our creditors, used to pester my father and beat him up, demanding their money back. So my father escaped and came here to earn and to pay them back. Earlier, my father used to work for others, plowing their fields. Then one day my mother said, look, before our bodies are broken completely, let us go to Delhi and work and try to pay them back.
It began thousands of years ago, this story that I now tell. It is our story and of our children and their children, and where it might end, I cannot tell. And when did it begin? This story was old already when we came to build the tomb of Emperor Humayun some centuries ago. Perhaps it was our ancestors who had come, or were they our children? There were no trains then, but the roads we take have always existed. Roads of despair, roads of helplessness. We leave our homes to journey down them to alien lands, to build tombs and to build cities. India Gate, the war memorial. Once we had come to build this too. On the stones are etched the names of hundreds of martyrs. But there's one name that is not mentioned, the name of a woman who, while carrying these stones, fell to her death. She was a migrant laborer. The passage of time has now blurred her name from my memory. Was she my sister or my mother? But so many lives have been sacrificed on these scaffoldings, and so many names forever lost. I cannot recall from where they came and when. And yes, the roads of despair and helplessness. What are they like? And why do we travel on them?
Whether we have marriages or whether we need to dig wells, we have to take a loan from the money lenders. We take loans to buy a buffalo, to buy seeds, to buy wood for our kitchen, to buy just anything. And at 3%, we can never pay them back. And since we can't repay, they confiscate our land or whatever little assets we have. Whatever they can find, our land, our cows, even our children are forced to plow their fields. All of us who come from Chhatarpur, from Madhya Pradesh, from Bihar or from Rajasthan, all of us are very poor. We are helpless. No one listens to us. And that is why we come to this alien place and spend our lives as laborers carrying bricks and cement. A person who doesn't have land, whose land is taken away from him, what will he do? He will loot. He will steal. He will feed his children even if he dies doing it. Because when he comes back home to his children in the evening and finds them hungry, he feels hurt.
And so we take to those roads, so familiar, yet so alien, to repay our debts and those of our ancestors, to construct buildings and to build cities. In the cities there are many who trade in our labor, but it sells cheap. For 10 hours a day we work with stone, concrete and steel to pay the labor contractor his commission and to earn 26 rupees. Nor is there ever the guarantee of daily employment.
My sister carries bricks or whatever she's asked to. And my mother, at times she works with the mason, at times she carries bricks. And at times it is off. At times there is no work. When I see my father in the evening after work, I feel terrible. I feel like going away from this bloody city. These men, they exploit my father and they still keep saying he doesn't work enough. All this after he works so hard every day. I just feel like running away from this place. But then I know we have to pay back the loan, so we must stay here, when nobody has any sympathy for a laborer.
Despite the poverty and desolation in the villages, beneath the open skies, there was a feeling of warmth and well-being. But they are dark and congested, our hovels and shanties in the labor camp. They are crowded and cramped, the narrow lanes. There are eternal squabbles over drinking water, and there's slush and infection and disease. Here in the cities, do we forget then that we are human, that we are real?
There is no place to play. If we go to play in front of the shopkeepers beat us. We see shit everywhere, even when we sit down to eat. I don't like it here. There is this stink all around and it gets into our bodies. We fall sick. In this city, no one cares for you, whether you live or you die. When our debt is paid back, we will go back to the village, never to return here. We will live there and my brother and I will go to school. My father will work in the fields and when we are grown up, we will take over from him.
Each time we grow to adulthood, we look at our children and ask ourselves, what future can we give them? How might we educate them? We search for answers and find none. Perhaps the child of a migrant laborer could only inherit the rubble, dust and the shanties.
Sir, I wanted my parents to send me to school so that when I'm older, I could get a job and take care of my father and my mother. I do wish to take up a job like everyone else does when they grow up. But I know I will never be able to study. And when I won't study, I won't get a job either. How can the child study? He won't be able to. Like me, he too will become a laborer and carry bricks. A child needs a steady life. Only then can he be successful.
We were born in little villages. We grew up there, nurtured by our heritage and traditions. We understand the passing of seasons, and we can tell when nature will turn to new colors. We know the wisdom of rituals and crafts and music. And despite the ravages of migrancy, we have a sense of stability, for we are deeply rooted in our culture. But our children, moving constantly, forget who they are and lose their roots. Their only tradition, their only certainty, is the journey that leads nowhere. Many are born to anonymity on nameless construction sites. There are those who were born on the site of some stadium. There are those who were born on the site of an embassy, and those who will never know what site it was. And thus, along the way, a million children lose their childhood. There is little parental caring. For parents must go away to look for work, leaving them behind. There are adult chores that the little hands must perform. An adult workload weighs down baby shoulders.
I get up early in the morning, perform the morning ablutions, come back and clean my teeth. Then I fetch water in a pot, gather the utensils and wash them. Then I sweep the floor, clean the house, bathe my brothers, comb their hair, change their clothes. Then I have a bath and carry my little brother to the site to be fed by my mother. And then I come to school.
School, the daycare center run by mobile creches. Toys in cradles, books in slates, colorful charts, posters, songs and drama, crafts and games. This is a place for nourishment and learning. This is a place of joy and laughter. A place where children reclaim their childhood. They need love and caring, the love and caring that toiling parents cannot give. For there are dreams in their eyes too, the dreams that lie lost in noise and dust, the little dreams all children dream.
The problem with a mother is this. Suppose she leaves a child on the roadside and she goes to work. Then there is nobody to take care of the child who can get run over by a car. If the child is playing at the site and someone throws concrete rubble from the top, the child can get killed. The women at the center take good care of the children. They feed them eggs and bananas and rice. They dress and comb them. They keep the children comfortable. And then the mothers can work in a carefree manner. The people at the center have helped some of our children gain admission to the municipal school nearby. Some of them are now in first class, some in second and some in third. The advantage with this center is that we mothers don't have to worry at all. There is no need to be on edge every second. We just leave the children here before going to work and pick them up in the evening. When the children are all here, we feed them breakfast and then hold classes for both the young and the very young ones. Then the younger ones go to sleep in the shade and the rest of them are taught drawing, paper folding, designing.
But our children cannot sustain their growth and learning at the center. This building is now completed and once again we must move to another site. Once again the endless journey must begin.
We stay at a site for 4 months and then we return to the village for 2 and then we are back and working at some place else.
And once again the questions come crowding back about the children and their future. The crisis is enormous and the solutions so elusive. Would there be another center at the new site? And if there is none, will again children lose their childhood amidst the concrete and stone? Will again little dreams lie lost in noise and dust?
Hey!